Hello everyone. In WebEx WebJS SDK, a new package has been introduced, that is calling package, also known as calling SDK. In this session, the primary focus will be on exploring the range of features offered by calling SDK and how to effectively navigate through its kitchen sink app to leverage those features. To access the kitchen sink app of calling SDK, the link is available under sample section of WebEx.js SDK in github.com. This is the link here. Once we click on it, we'll be redirected to this page where the samples page for different packages are available. Since we are using calling, we'll just go ahead and click on this tab and the kitchen sink app for calling SDK will open right here. To get started with this page, we will require access token. The token can be retrieved using developer portal link that is attached here. I have clicked on it and it's opening. Using your user credentials, we can log in to the developer portal. I have already logged in here successfully and my access token is available here. I can go ahead and click on this button to copy the access token. Come back to the Kitchen Sink app and paste the token here. After this step is done, we also have the option to choose the environment. We can click on this button to go to the integration mode, or we can keep it in the production. For my user, it's a production environment user, so I'll keep it in this mode itself and continue. We also have advanced settings available where we can choose for which service we are using the calling SDK for. By default, it is set to calling, so I am not going to change anything. If we are using calling SDK in contact center, we can change the service mode to contact center, but I'm just going to keep it in calling. Also, there is region and country available to be set here before initializing the calling instance. We have multiple clusters available for the calling backend in different region and country. So if we want to use a specific cluster, we can specify the region and country here. I just want it to be picked up by default. So I'm going to leave this blank. Now I can go ahead and click on this button, initialize calling, which will do the initialization of the calling instance on the backend. Once that is done, the register button has become active as it was disabled earlier. Now we can go ahead and click the register button to proceed with the registration of the device with WebEx calling. Once the registration action is successful, we will see the status here as registered and the device ID will be populated here that is generated for the device. If we want to deregister the device, we can click on this unregister button and that will take care of it. Moving on to the next feature, which is inbound and outbound calls. In order to receive an inbound call or trigger an outbound call, we first need to get the media permissions. For audio call, we will require microphone and speaker permissions. And for video call, we will also require the camera permission. So we can click on this Get Media Streams button and that will take care of fetching these permissions for us. We also have these placeholders available in this place, which will show you the local video and remote video streams once we have the camera permissions. But these are just the placeholders as of now because we do not support video call. It's just audio call. Also, we have the background noise reduction effect available to be enabled over the audio call. I'm going to proceed without enabling it for now. To trigger the outbound call, we can just put the destination number here in this text box and click on this Make Call button. What this will do is it will trigger the outbound call for this destination. I already have this user logged in another tab. So let's do that. And the moment the call is triggered, we saw that the status came here as call progress and the end call button became active and make call is disabled. I have answered the call from the other end, and the status changed to call established, and the call ID is also appearing here. Why this disabling and enabling of these buttons was done? So that we should not be able to trigger another outbound call while one call is in progress, and the end call comes active the moment we trigger an outbound call, so that we can disconnect the call at any stage of the call. I'm going to disconnect, and this button will become disabled again, and the make call will become active. Also, the status will get updated here as call disconnected for this call ID. Next, I will trigger the inbound call for this user. The moment we receive the incoming call on this page, the answer button has come active and the make call has become disabled. I'll click on this to answer the call. Call will move to the established state and the end call button will come active for me to be able to disconnect the call. I'll go ahead and click on this button to disconnect it. The status got updated, and as before, again we have this button enabled to be able to trigger an outbound call. Next feature is that we have call controls available. Supplementary services like hold resume, line transfer, consult transfer are available, and mute unmute feature is also there on the call. I'll go ahead and trigger an outbound call so that we should be able to see the features, supplementary services features. So now the call is in connected state. I'll click on this hold button to trigger the call hold. The other party will hear music on hold the moment hold operation is successful. And here the call status will also get updated as call is held. And the button will also get toggled to resume. Now we can click on the same button to resume the call. The call status will get updated here once the action is successful, call is resumed, and the button will also go back to the hold. And on the other user side, I can hear the audio again, and the music and hold is stopped. So that was hold resume. Coming to the transfer feature, like I said, we have two options available here, blind transfer and consult transfer. First, we will see the example of blind transfer. So let me just go ahead and put the destination number of the target where I would like to transfer my call to. In order to trigger the transfer, my call is already in connected state here. I'll just go ahead and click on this button. And since in the drop-down, blind transfer is selected, it's done. First, I have received the call on the transfer target and I have answered the call. But on this user's end, the moment the transfer was successful, status got updated here as transferred successfully, and this call leg got dropped. So the call status also got updated that call is disconnected. But on the other end, the transfer target and my previous called party are connected to each other. Now we'll quickly see the example of transfer target as well. So I'll go ahead and trigger a fresh call again. The user is ringing, answered the call. Call is in connected state now. I will put the transfer target here again, choose consult transfer, and click on this transfer button. Now in case of consult transfer, first my transfer target will get connected with this user from where the transfer is initiated. And only when I click the same button again, the transfer will happen where this user will get disconnected from both the calls one with the previous called party and another call with the transfer target, and transfer target and the previous called party will get connected to each other. So we'll just see that flow. So I clicked on the transfer. I'm receiving the call on the transfer target. I have answered the call. And my previous called party is in hold state. The transfer is not completed yet. Only the transfer target is in connected state. Now I have to click on this button again to finish the transfer. That's where the actual transfer happens and the status gets updated here. And here, as we can see, finally this call got disconnected and the transfer target and the previous called party are connected to each other. So that was all to be covered as part of this video. We'll cover remaining features in the next video. Thank you.